Hello friends, welcome to Jobme Tech Solutions. Today we are going to learn how to install Apache and MySQL server in your computer. There are many server services pre-built setups available online. You can find hundreds of them. But we will use XAMPP pre-built server installer. This is not a sponsor for XAMPP, but XAMPP is being widely used for MariaDB, PHP and Perl. First thing we need to do is to download the XAMPP setup. So go to google.com and type XAMPP. You will see a search result from apachefriends.org, so click on download link for XAMPP. Now here you can see a bunch of different versions. XAMPP allows you to choose different PHP versions. We have PHP 7 right now. Many users are still using PHP 5.6, so if you are one of them, so you can download it here easily. Now navigate to the directory where you have downloaded the file. Open it to install. Skip the warning message. Click on next button. Leave all options as they are. Hit on next button. Now here you can change your installation directory. I am happy with what it is right now, because installing on different drives can cause some critical problems for my MySQL database. So now hit on next 3 more times to start installation. We will always take a stand for the people. After installation, uncheck start the control panel now and hit on finish button. Now if you want to start Apache and MySQL services on Windows startup, then open XAMPP control with administration. Click on Red Cross near Apache and MySQL to install their services for a startup. And then click on Start for both to start their services. Now open PHP MyAdmin into your web browser by providing localhost/phpMyAdmin as address in address bar. Here you can see a MySQL database server. Now click on new to create new database. Type database name and click on create button. After database creation, you can create table. So name your table and provide number of columns for your table. Then click on go to create table. Now here it shows your table columns to provide their properties. After providing your columns properties, click on save button to save your table. Now click on table name to browse its data. Right now we don't have data inserted, so click on insert to insert a record as data and provide your data in fields. Then click on go to save your record data. Click on browse to browse your table's data. You can use SQL syntax to practice your queries. Click on SQL. Here I am writing a simple query which selects name from persons and click on go button to get data. You can see our query worked and gave name from persons. So guys, that's all for today. Hope we will meet in next video. Until you guys should like, comment and subscribe to my channel. If you are new or have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit on bell icon to get latest videos notifications. Thanks for watching.